Geographic Information Systems, or we just call it GIS, are a set of mapping and data-driven technologies for dealing with geographical problems, answering geographical questions. Then they're used in a lot of different kinds of both natural science, business, health-oriented fields. They are professional-grade data and software and hardware. It's a wide variety of career paths. There are social science applications, things like city and urban planning, things like Department of Transportation or the FDNY, or in environmental conservation, things like the City Parks Department hires a lot of folks who do this sort of stuff. There's also a lot of environmental research, things like where are the invasive species, where are the endangered species, where are the protected lands. We also frequently have students coming in with a journalistic or communications-oriented interest set, so things like data journalism, building data-driven, data-weighty stories about what's happening in the world today. The examples like the New York Times, the Washington Post, Vox Media, all have geographic information graphics departments who are telling graphic stories, and GIS is part of the data stuff that makes those stories possible. We also see things in public health, epidemiology. I have a couple of epidemiology students in my classes right now. Other things are business, things like I actually worked in real estate for a while using my GIS certifications and experience, but also things like marketing. Where is your audience? How much money do they make? What are their cultural preferences? And by better knowing your audience and knowing where they are, you can better market to them. We're launching the new Bachelor of Science degree on top of the Bachelor of Arts degree that we already have in Geography and GIS, and to give students a choice. It's because with a Bachelor of Arts degree, the one we've already got, you can get a wide-based liberal arts education in geography, the social science of that, and with GIS technical training. The BS, the Bachelor of Science degree, allows students to focus on the science and technology aspects of GIS as a field, and with that, tailor it to specific kinds of technological careers. It also has the additional upshot of if you're majoring in a BS degree track, something like biology, it allows you to pick up the BS in GIS as a second major. You can't do that with a BA. We have a new minor in computer science and geographic information systems as a way of offering students a very quick introduction to coding and GIS. You know, it's writing software, writing apps, and working with GIS, which is a natural synergy between the two programs, even though it's two different departments here at Hofstra. And by having that minor, you can get just a taste of it. So if you're majoring in journalism or you're majoring in health professions, you can at least get some coding experience and some geographic experience if you want to spin that out into the fields. And being able to say, I both code and I can work with geographic data, which is a rarefied combination of skills, is tremendously useful. You know, obviously you'll get more with a major, but at least to get some people some basic foundations in that stuff, we've got the computer science and GIS minor.